Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 2271, Fuzzy Lookup in Excel. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill John. Now, this is an awesome tool that was created by Microsoft Labs all the way back in 2013. I think they were maybe thinking of adding this technology to Excel, but it actually got added to another product and never made it to Excel. But the add-in is still out there. And to get the add-in, you're going to have to go to this download location. I'll put that down in the YouTube comments, so you don't have to type it and scroll down here and click download. They have details. This is version 1.3, all the way back from 2014. You need Excel 2010 or newer. And once you install it successfully, you have this fuzzy lookup tab, but it's really hard to figure out what's going on. So you want to go to File, Options, go to Add-ins, click on Fuzzy Lookup, and this directory here, go to that directory, and you will find this awesome stuff right here, the portfolio sample and the README that explains how it works. Without this, you don't have a chance. All right, so we're going to walk through their portfolio example. And what we have here is there's four tables in this example. The first table, Table Tools Design, is called Portfolio. It's, you know, our portfolio. This is the stocks we own and the shares. And then here is a table of the S&P 500. And of course, you know, the names here don't match the names here, which is so typical. I mean, someone misspelled the company name here. It's just a mess. And then if you go into the instructions or that Word document, they'll talk about these two tables here called Transformations and TokenWeights, and you can explain, you know, that Inc. and Incorporated, Corp. and Corporation mean the same thing, and ignore things like NPV and USD, some junk data that's here like NPV and you know, some other things. So it just knows to throw those out. All right. So here's how it works. Go to the fuzzy lookup, and we'll get a little panel over here on the right-hand side. Specify the left table and then the right table. There's drop-downs there. What's really nice is you can specify two columns in theory, but here it's just one column, the company in the left table and company in the right column, right table. And then which do we want to output? Do we want everything from that other table or not? At the end, this fuzzy lookup similarity, you definitely want to ask for that. And we're going to talk about this number of matches. Now, by default, they do one, and to me that is super, super risky. I've used fuzzy match in the past, this tool and other tools, and using just the top match is really just kind of a disaster, right? There's no silver bullet here that's going to solve all problems. This is really going to help you. It's going to try and find matches, but you really need to ask for them to provide two matches at least, or three matches, so that way a human, an intelligent human, can go through and figure out which match is correct. But for right now, I'm just going to click go. All right. And so here's, these two columns are my original table, company and shares. It's interesting, they don't make it into a table. And then here is the matching data from the S&P 500. All right. So Amazon, com, Inc. stock. See, they threw out the Inc. and stock, and they were able to figure out Amazon.com, Inc. Motorola, great. AT&T, great. Berkshire Hathaway, misspelled, just terribly misspelled, but they got it. Microsoft, Coca-Cola, Dr. Pepper was matched to Dr. Pepper, or Pepper Snapple Group. Autodesk, they threw out the junk at the end thanks to our transformations table and figured out it was Autodesk. And then Mellon Bank. Boy, this one, this always amazes me because it's not even close. Mellon and Bank are in the wrong order, but it found it. We can come out here to the far right-hand side and look for that similarity. And so that's down at 86%. Not the worst one. The worst one here is at 81%, where they matched AT&T Corp. to AT&T Inc. Only had an 81% similarity. All right, now here's why I think that you should never do the top match. I think you always want to come here and ask for at least two or three and see what they come up with. All right, yeah, three, what the heck, and then we'll click go. All right, now the difference here is we're going to get more rows than we had in the original data set. And each row in the original data set might return up to three matches. And it's up to you to go figure out which is the right match. For example, Motorola, there's actually two companies in the S&P 500 that could be a match, Motorola Solutions and Motorola Mobility Holdings. Down here, Coca-Cola, you have the Coca-Cola company, that's one organization and then Coca-Cola Enterprises, and you might have wanted CCE instead of KO. And then let's see, that's the only, AT&T. I love this one. This is a great example of why fuzzy match can return the wrong results. If you look at AT&T Corp and ITT Corporation, that's only off by one character when you get right down to it. And this one, has an extra ampersand, and we're really, really lucky that we got the correct one there. It very could have easily happened that we would have gotten ITT Corp as the number one match. That's why every time that I do a fuzzy match, I always ask for two, and then I take a little bit of time just to go through and validate that the match that they found is really the best match. I mean, some of these, you'll find a match, especially at 50%, that isn't the same company at all. But sometimes, Coca-Cola and Coca-Cola Enterprises, I might have needed CCE. So it's always worth the time just to ask for two matches and then manually go through and look at them. And I get it. If you have 10,000 rows, no one's going to want to go through and look at 10,000 rows. But, you want your data to be right. And this tool is so much easier than going through and manually matching them up, which is what we have to resort to a lot of the time. All right. Now, hey, thanks to Liam Bastic at sumproduct.com. I had seen this tool many years ago, back in 2013, and then it was lost. I couldn't find it. There was actually a podcast, 400 or 500 podcasts ago. This thing was a killer, horrible process, 10, 12 steps. And step number 7 desperately needed the fuzzy lookup tool, and I couldn't find it. So I had to write back to the guy. I said, hey, I have this installed on my machine, but I can't find anywhere where they'll let you download it. So I can't give you the solution because you're not going to be able to get past step 7. So thanks to Liam for knowing that it's out there. The other thing that slightly fears me, that strikes some fear into my heart, is it's currently March 4th, 2019 when I'm recording this, and the help document says that support goes, or the license goes through July of 2019, which means that you only have, 3 months left. So, hey, if you think you're ever going to need the fuzzy lookup anytime in the rest of your life, go download it now, all right, because who knows when July comes. There's a good chance they won't extend this and you won't be able to download it anymore. It's an awesome little tool, thanks to Microsoft Labs. That's the group at Microsoft that, isn't charged with making revenue. They're just charged with making cool stuff, and this is cool stuff. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.